pray really fast so we can kind of get our focus, and then we will get started. So, dear Jesus, I thank you for this time that we're here, and thank you for bringing us here. I pray that you would help us to calm down and be able to focus, and I pray that you would speak to our hearts and that you teach us all something new. And God, we love you so much. And here I pray. Amen. All right, so if any of you knows me, and if any of you have ever gotten a ride from me in my car, you will know that directions is something that I am terrible at, okay? Like awful. Like, I get lost all the time. Even if I have Siri saying, like, turn right here, or turn left, or turn around. She says that to me a lot. You need to make a U-turn. So I get lost all the time, okay? And I remember when I was, how old are you when you get lost? 16 or 15? 16. Okay, so I was about 16 years old, okay, almost 17, and I just got my license, and I was, when I first got my license, my dad would not let me drive myself for like 4 weeks after I got my license. I was like, what the heck? I like just got my license, that means I passed the test, that means they think I'm a good enough driver to be on the road, but he wouldn't let me drive. So finally, my parents were like, okay, you can start going places. But I had to, does anybody's mom make them text when they like get somewhere or text when they leave? Or,
yes.
Yeah. So annoying, right? But it's for our protection. So my mom would make me text her every time I got somewhere and every time I would leave somewhere, okay? And this was one of the first times I was able to drive myself. And I wanted to go to my friend Sam's house. And I lived in Fallbrook, and Fallbrook, if you've been there before, has a bunch of tiny streets that some of them lead places, some of them don't lead anywhere. Some of them are dirt, some of them like are nice, all that stuff. But it's easy to get lost in Fallbrook, okay? And my mom told me to print out the maps, okay? If you're like, what does print out the maps mean? We didn't have Google MapQuest on our phone. I know, what did we do without it? Well, let me tell you what we did without it. We would print out our directions what was called MapQuest, okay? And we'd print them out on a piece of paper and we'd just have to read them and look at them, okay? And my mom was like, print out directions to your house on MapQuest. And I was like, I've been there before, like, I can get there, I'm fine. And my mom was like, okay, well, you have to text me when you get there. I'm like, okay. So I'm driving to Sam's house and it was like light outside. And all of a sudden, like, she lives like 15 minutes away from my house. And 30 minutes later, it's dark and I have no clue where I am. Okay, I'm just like lost in the boonies of Fallbrook, all right? I'm like, where the heck is her street? I'm like driving all around. And also, my directional skills mixed with the dark is like the worst thing ever. And so I'm like, I turn my music off. For some reason that when I'm lost, I have to turn my music down as if it's gonna help me see better, okay? So I turn my music off and I'm like, okay, I need to call Sam. So I call Sam, I'm like, Sam, like, I'm lost. And she's like, okay, I'm gonna tell you where my house is. She's like trying to explain it to me. And my mom, he's trying to call me on the other line. And with iPhones, it like tells you, oh, someone else is trying to call you right now, right? Well, my phone didn't do that, so I didn't know my mom was calling me. And apparently she was so freaked out that she called my friend Sam, her boyfriend's mom, and the boyfriend's mom called the boyfriend, who called Sam's mom, because Sam was on the phone with me, so she didn't answer. And my mom almost called 911 because she thought I had gotten in a car accident and died, okay? And I'm just lost in the streets of Fallbrook somewhere. And needless to say, I got in a ton of trouble. I wasn't allowed to drive by myself for a couple of weeks. And my mom always told me that I'd print out MapQuest from then on. But the reason I told you that story is because I wanted to do it my way. I didn't want to look at the maps. I didn't want to listen to my mom. I wanted to do it the way that I wanted to do it because I thought it was easier my way. I was like, oh, I know what I'm doing. I've got it under control. I thought that I had control of the situation. And today we're going to look at a story of a guy in the Bible. And this is a story that you guys have all probably heard multiple times. But we're going to look at the story of this guy named Jonah and how he decided to do his own thing because he thought it was better than what God wanted for him. So if you guys have your Bibles or your phone Bible, I want you to open up with me to Jonah, the book of Jonah. It's in the Old Testament. You go past Psalms, Proverbs, Song of Solomon, Jeremiah. It's in like all the weird books that we don't really know about, but it's in there. So Jonah chapter 1. you're there, say, I'm there. If you're not, say, hold on. We're going to start in Jonah chapter 1. Jonah chapter 1. If you're there, is anyone else there? I'm there. Is anyone not there yet? Chapter 1. Okay, I'm going to start. If you are still looking, just let you get there. Every Bible is different, but in my Bible, it's page 841. Is that helpful? Verses 514. All right, so I'm going to be starting in verse 1, and then I'm going to be jumping around and summarizing it a bit, so if you get lost, don't worry, just... I'll eventually shout out what verse we're at so you can catch up. So, verse 1. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, son of Amittai, and it said, go to the city of Nineveh and preach against it, because its wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah did what? Ran away from the Lord and headed for Tarshish. He went down to Joppa, where he found a ship bound for port. After paying the fare, he went aboard the ship and sailed to Tarshish to flee from the Lord. So Jonah, Jesus comes to Jonah and he says, I want you to go to I want you to go to Nineveh, and I want you to preach to these people because their wickedness has become so great that they need to hear about Jesus, and I want you to go do it. And Jonah says, no, and he does what? He runs away, and he gets on a boat, and he pays the fare, and he gets on a boat, and he tries to flee to Tarshish. Then verse 4, it says, then the Lord sent a great wind on the sea, and such a violent storm arose that the ship threatened to break. All the sailors were afraid, and they cried out each to their own God, and they threw the cargo into the sea to lighten the ship. But Jonah had gone down below deck where he lay down, and he fell into a deep what? Sleep. Okay, so Jonah gets onto this boat, right? And he's trying to flee from God. And he gets on this boat, and all of a sudden, what happens? Storm. And it starts tossing the boat around, and the guys in the boat are freaking out, so they start praying to their gods, and they start throwing cargo over the side of the boat. And then Jonah is doing what? Sleeping, okay? So I'm not going to read it, but some of the guys go down there, and they wake him up, and they're like, what the heck are you doing? Like, get up here. Like, we're all praying to our gods. We need you to come pray to your God. And they asked him, they said, who is your God? And he says in verse 9, he answered them, and he said, I'm a Hebrew, and I worship the Lord, the God of the heaven, who made the sea and the dry land. This terrified them, and they asked, what have you done? So they're on this boat, and they're like, we need to worship our gods. So Jonah, you need to get up, like, wake up from your sleep, come worship your God, like, ask him to stop. And they said, who is your God? And he's like, oh, my God is the God who created the ocean and the land. And they're like, what did you do? They're like, we're on the ocean right now, and it's going berserk, and your God created this. Like, what could you have done wrong to cause this to happen? And in verse 11, it says, the sea was getting rougher and rougher, so they asked him, what should we do to make the sea calm down for us? He said, pick me up and do what? Throw me into the sea, he replied, and it will become calm. I know that this is my fault, that the great storm has come upon. But instead, the men did their best to row back to land, but they could not, for the sea grew even wilder and wilder. And then in verse 15, it says, then they took Jonah, they threw him overboard, and the raging sea grew immediately, what?
Calm.
At this, the men greatly feared the Lord, and they offered sacrifice to the Lord, and made vows to him. So, they're in this boat, it's going crazy, and they bring Jonah up, and they said, who's your God? And he said, my God created the ocean and the land. And they're like, what the heck did you do wrong to make your God this mad? And he said, I'm sorry, it's my fault, just throw me into the ocean. And they were like, no, we want to sail you back to shore, but they couldn't make it because the ocean was too crazy. So they were like, all right, what are we going to do? So they did what? They chucked him into the sea, and the sea immediately grew calm. Crazy, right? And then it says that the men feared the Lord, and they offered sacrifice. So the men are like, oh my gosh, this God, like, just made the ocean crazy, and we threw a person in, and it stopped going crazy. Like, he's insane. So they start worshiping Jesus, okay? And then this is the last verse we're going to read right now. In verse 17, it says, now the Lord, what? What's that word that it says in your Bible? The Lord did what?
Provide.
He provided. My Bible says provided. I don't know what yours says. But if you have a pen, I want you to circle that word or underline that word or something. But it says, now the Lord provided a huge fish to swallow Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the fish for 3 days and three nights. From the inside of the fish, Jonah prayed to the Lord. And we'll get to his prayer later. But we have this crazy story of Jonah getting thrown into the ocean, and he gets swallowed by a fish, right? I wish I knew what this fish looked like. I know that a lot of us have thought that it's a whale, and that's what it's taught. Even I thought it was a whale, and after service, Taylor was like, you don't even know if it was a whale. It said, the Bible says fish. So it's one massive fish, all right? And it just comes up, and it swallows Jonah whole, right? And Jonah's inside this fish. So we are going to jump back to verse 1. And the reason I shared my map story was because I was saying that it was something that I wanted to do, right? And it was the way that I wanted to go. And this story is the same with Jonah. God asked him to do one thing, right? And instead he wanted to do something else. And he wanted to go his own way. And I'm gonna, if you wanna click the map in there, Danny, we have a map of what it might have looked like. And Joppa right there, the bottom of the red arrow, is where Jonah was. And the red arrow points to where God wanted him to go. And then that long little skinny thing that goes all the way out to Spain, Tarshish, is where he wanted to go. Right? How close is that to God's plan? Not close at all, right? And Jonah wanted to do his own thing. And Jonah thought that his plan was easier and better than God's. He thought that he would rather be in control of the situation, right? He was like, I don't want to go to Nineveh. I don't want to preach to them. I don't want to go there. I want to go my own way. And that is to Tarshish. And I'm going to get on a boat and I'm going to do my own thing because I think that my plan is easier and my plan is better. And how many times do we, as human beings, think that our plan is better than God's, right? It's not. Good job. But how many times do we think that, right? Maybe it's at school. Maybe you think, oh, it would be easier to cheat on this test or to cheat on my homework because that's easier than studying, right? But God asks us to be honest, right? And he asks us to have integrity in the way that we do life. Or maybe it's in the way we talk. God asks us to talk righteously and to talk pure and clean. But how easy is it for us to want to go our own way, to gossip, or to cuss, or to say things about other people that are hurtful, or to not speak in love, right? Because that's easier, and that's the way that we want to go, not the way that God asks us to go. Or maybe that's in our relationships with other people. God asks us to stay pure and to be careful, and it's easier for us to do our own thing and do it the way that we want instead of the way that God wants. And today we're going to call that the easy path. And the easy path is our way. It's the way that we think is best for us and not what God thinks is best for us. And my first point that I have for you guys is just because it's easy doesn't make it right. Just because it's easy does not make it right. And Jonah thought that his plan was the right thing to do. He thought, I'm going to get on a boat. I'm going to sail away to Tarshish. I'm going to get as far away from God's plan as I can. Because that is easier for me to do than to listen and obey God. And maybe we think at school that cheating is way easier for us than studying and spending a long time on our homework and making sure we're doing the right thing and not cheating. But is cheating right? Is talking in a way that's not loving or that's inappropriate or that's rude or hurtful, is that right? Is that what God asks us to do? Is acting the wrong way in our relationship with other people the right thing to do? Is disrespecting our parents and our friends and our teachers the right thing to do? No. But we think that it's easier, right? And we think that it's easier to do what I feel like doing and what my way of doing things than to do it the way that God asks us to do it. There's a verse, and you don't need to follow me there, but there's a verse in Proverbs, and it says, Many are the plans in a person's heart, but it's the Lord's purpose that prevails. We have lots of ways that we want to go, lots of things that we want to do that are in our means, that are easy for us and good for us. But it's the purpose and the guidance of God that brings that to be right. And Jonah did something he wasn't supposed to do, right? He fled from God. He wasn't obedient to God. And he ended up where? He ended up in the belly of a fish. He was on an ocean. He was on a boat with a bunch of sailors, and the waves were crashing onto the boat. His consequences of his sin were smashing against the boat, right? And they were affecting the sailors, right? They were affecting other people who didn't do anything wrong. And sometimes the choices that we make in our sin can affect other people, even though they have nothing to do with it. And then they got so fed up with it that they threw Jonah into the ocean, and Jonah was swallowed by a giant fish, right? And he ended up in a place that I'm sure Jonah did not want to be. I bet you Jonah did not wake up that morning and think, I would love to be inside a belly of a fish today. That sounds like a great idea to me, right? I'm sure that's not what he was thinking. And sometimes the choices that we make, the easy path, could take us somewhere that we don't want to be. And that's my second point, is that sometimes the easy path could take us somewhere we don't want to be. And how lonely do you think it was inside of the whale? I mean, maybe there was some other, like, creatures or something in there. I don't know. But I bet you it was pretty smelly, and I bet you it was lonely, and it was dark. And how many times does our sin make us feel that way? How many times does doing the wrong thing make us feel lonely? Or maybe we have guilt and shame and it makes us feel scared. Or it makes us feel frustrated. Or it's dark and it's scary. And it's not a place that we want to be, right? And maybe our sin will take us somewhere we don't want to be physically, like in life. Maybe we'll end up in a situation we don't want to be. But also spiritually with God, it could take us to a lonely place that we don't want to be when we're taking our own path, right? Next. And Jonah ended up in the belly of a fish, which I'm sure he didn't want to be, but he got there because he decided to take the easy path. And it took him somewhere he didn't want to be. And then Jonah was sitting inside of the whale, and he began to pray to God. And that's where we're going to pick it back up. If you have your Bible still open in Jonah, we're going to be in chapter 2. And listen closely, it says, he prayed to God, and he said, in my distress I called to you, Lord, and you answered me. From deep in the realm of the dead I called for help, and you listened to my cry. You hurled me into the depths and into the very heart of the seas, and the currents swirled around me. All your waves and breakers swept over me. I said, I have been banished from your sight, yet I will look again towards your holy temple. The engulfing waters threatened me, and the deep surrounded me. Seaweed was wrapping around my head. To the roots of the mountains I sank, down the earth beneath, buried me in forever. But you, Lord, my God, brought my life up from the pit. So Jonah's in the belly of the whale, and he realizes he needs to make a choice. And he calls out to God, and he says, God, like, I've messed up. I realized what I did wrong. This is my fault. And God, I want to be part of your plan again. I want to come back. I want you to forgive me. And if we take the easy path, if we take the path that we want to take, we're going to come to a point where we have to make the same decision. And that's my third point, is that you guys are going to have to, you will be caused to choose destruction or redemption. Destruction or redemption. If you're taking your own path, Danny, you can click it. If you're taking your own path and you're doing your own thing and you're not listening to God's plan, you will be caused to make a decision of destruction or redemption. And I know destruction sounds like a scary word, but I want to read a verse to you guys. It's in Matthew, and you have a note sheet and you're taking notes, I would write this down. Matthew 7, verse 13. Matthew 7, verse 13 says, enter through the narrow gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it, but small is the gate, and narrow the road that leads to life. And only few will find it. So, when you see, like, something wide, is it easier to go for something big or something small?
Big.
Big, right? Because that's easier. And that's what a lot of other people will do. And that's what the Bible says. It says, wide is the gate, that many will go through, but it leads to what? Destruction, right? And it says, narrow is the gate that few will find, but it leads to what? But it leads to life. But it leads to life. And God says, I want you to follow me, and I want you to be in my plan. I know it's going to be harder, but it's going to lead to what? Life. And it says, your plan is easier, right? And it might sound like a better idea. And it's wider, but it's going to lead to what? Destruction. If we don't choose God, and if we don't choose to follow his plan. And Jonah made a mistake. And Jonah went his own way. He went on that long trip to Tarshish to get as far away from God as he could because he thought that Jonah's plan was easier than God's. And how many times do we think that our plan is easier than God's plan? And how many times do we go our own way instead of choosing what God has already laid out for us? There's a verse in Jeremiah 29:11 that says, for I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans of peace and not evil to give you a future and a hope. He's already laid out his plan for you, and it's a perfect plan. It's full of peace and hope. But we like to choose to go the hard way and end up in a lonely place in the belly of a fish. And then in verse 10 of chapter 2, it says that God commanded the whale to vomit him onto the dry land and go preach in Nineveh. And Jonah realized that he needed to go back to God, and he wanted to be back in God's plan. And guys, this is the most important part that I want you to hear today, is that it's okay if we make a mistake, because we're all going to go our own way at some point in our life, right? Maybe we do it every day. We take our own plan instead of God's. But God said, you can still come back to me, and I will forgive you, and I will let you be part of my plan. And that's what Jonah asked. He said, let me be part of your plan again. And God brought him to Nineveh, and Jonah was able to continue what God had asked him to do. So my challenge for you guys is, you can click it, Danny, is to find what areas you are choosing your plan and ask God if you can be back in his. So find the areas in your life where you're choosing to do your own thing and pray to God and ask him to be back in his plan like Jonah. So I'm going to pray, and don't forget about offering and the prayer cards. And once I'm done praying, please be respectful as Thomas comes back up here. It's really frustrating when you guys get up and start doing your own thing, because we still have some more stuff to do. So if you could bow your heads, close your eyes. Hey, God, I thank you so much for this time that you brought us here. I thank you for teaching us the lesson of Jonah and just teaching us what it looks like to follow your plan instead of our own. I pray that we would apply this to our lives as we go home this week.